everyone. I'm Sajit Kariosan, Associate Technical Lead from WSO2. In WSO2 API Manager 2.0, we have revamped all the user interfaces to provide a better user experience. During this screencast, I'm going to walk you through the new API Store. Using this link, you can log into the API Store. If you have a user account already created, you can use this sign-in link, or else if you don't have a user account, you can use sign up link to create a user account by giving all the filling all the details in this form. Since I have already created a user account, I'm going to use that account to log into this portal. As you can see, the look and feel is very different from the previous versions of this API Manager. The menu panel is moved into the left side. You can find APIs here, applications, forums, and statistics here. The search panel is moved into here. You can find different types of APIs, whether it's production or prototyped APIs. For this screencast, I'm going to use this PizzaShack API, and I'm going to subscribe to this API using I'm going to create a new application for that. I'll be providing a name as my pizza application, and I'm going to select a quota which allows 50 requests per minute. And now I have added that application. In order to subscribe to that application, I need to select a tier. I'm going to select the gold tier, which allows 5000 requests per minute, and I'm going to subscribe to the API. Now the subscription is successful. I can see that in the subscriptions tab. I have subscribed to the PizzaShack API. If you go into the details, you can see the status and the quota details and description. In the key section, you can see the access tokens generated. But here, I have not generated any access tokens yet. I'm going to create access tokens now. One thing to notice, the grant types in this version of API Manager, we have moved grant types into the API Store. You can configure, select or unselect the required grant types as required. You will see the code and name, code grant type and the implicit grant types are hidden. That's because I haven't provided any callback URL. If I provide a callback URL, you will see the code and implicit grant types gets highlighted. The access token validity period is also configurable. I'm going to set 7200 seconds, and I have generated the keys now. You can show and hide the keys in here. In this section, you will find the sample curl commands to generate access tokens using password grant types as well as the client credential grant type. The access token can be found here. Now I'm going to the API console to invoke the API. I'm going to select, I need to select the specific application, and you will see the access token is automatically populated here. I'm going to select the get operation, and I have now executed that, and you can see the response code is 200 OK, which is successful, and you can find the response has been received in here. So that's the get resource. Now let's move on to the post resource. In the post resource, you need to provide the body parameters You can find the sample parameters, the sample JSON here. I have already copied that JSON and I'm going to invoke the post resource as well. But if you see the response, you will see the response code is for 403, which is forbidden. The response has been failed, stating that the access token does not allow you to access the requested resource. The reason for that is, while creating the API in API Publisher, this is the UI of API Publisher, as you can see, I have provided a scope named PISA order to the post resource of the API. That is to control the access level to that specific resource, so that if the generated access token does not fall within that scope, the access is forbidden. That is the reason for the failure. While generating the access token, we have not selected any scope, so that the access token is not generated for that particular scope. So let's go to the key generation UI and regenerate the keys. So I'm going to the keys section again, and in here, if you notice, you can select the scopes. In the drop down, you can select the PISA order scope, which I have already created using API Publisher, and I can regenerate the tokens. Now the tokens are regenerated, and if you go to the API console again, and provide the body parameters and invoke the post operation. Now you will see the response has been successful, and the post operation was successful, and the order is created, and the order ID is, you have received an order ID. Now that is because the access token we regenerated, we selected the scope, particular scope, and that access token falls within that scope. That concludes my screencast. I hope it helped you to get a good idea on the new user experience on API Store. For more information on WSO2 API Manager, you can visit our documentation site. Thank you.